Hey guys, it's Marina Janelle here, and I thought that I would make a video about my horseback riding accident so I could tell all of you guys in person what happened about a week ago, exactly a week ago today. So here you go. Here's our in-person chat of what happened to me last Monday. So it was just like any other day until all of a sudden it was not. I was out on a ride with my friend Heather, and we had our horses that were both leasing. And we had the best ride. We discovered a lot of different trails and it was super fun. And we did some running and we just had some good talks. And then at the towards the end, we're like 3 minutes from the barn on horseback. And she's like, hey, do you want to run one more time? Or one last time? And of course, I'm like, heck yeah, my favorite thing to do is run. So we get going and we're flying. And the wind is in my hair, and it's just like magical. And then all of a sudden, my horse, Lucy, trips. And so this is where it all goes down, literally. So she trips on her front feet. We still don't know what she tripped on, but she tripped, and my feet were caught in the stirrups. And so I was trying to lean back and pulled my feet up, and my knees hit the ground the same time as her face hit the ground. And then we somersaulted, and then at some point, I don't remember this whole part, but at some point I got out of the stirrups and I got out and I landed here and she landed here. And at this point, Heather's horse Sedona turned around because of all of the ruckus. I may or may not have screamed a naughty word, and then I jumped up automatically because usually, or a lot of times, horses can spook after an accident like this, and so I didn't want her to run away because we would have had to like go through a huge intersection to get back to the barn. So I jumped up without thinking, which was maybe good, maybe not, and immediately like the pain in my knees just like hit me. But I grabbed her reins because she was getting up around the same time. So I grabbed her reins, and then Heather kind of like made it back around this point too, and she jumped off her horse and grabbed Lucy from me because at this point I passed out. So I fell to the ground, and then I don't remember if it was the first time that I passed out or the second time, but at one point I had a dream during when I was out that about this accident, and so the same exact thing, but then it was like it was over and it was done and it was white and it was like, okay, like horseback riding accident and I died. And then I hear like Marina, Marina, and it's Heather, and I'm like, oh, I was just like, it was just a dream. And then I like open my eyes and my face is against the dirt and I'm like, what? Like, why was I taking a nap? My first thought is, why was I taking a nap in the middle of the trail? I must have been like really tired. And then all of a sudden the pain came back and then I realized, oh shoot, that dream was actually real, but I didn't die, but I'm in a ton of pain. And then I just remember holding my knees. My knees were actually stuck up right here. They were like stuck bent. And I was just holding them like my knees are broken, my knees are broken. And it was just like incredible pain. So she calls the lady who owns my horse and calls her down to the barn, and then calls Zach and sends Zach to the barn and then has the lady come. And so this guy, the lady who owns my horse, came and carried me because we were like a quarter mile from a road, so on trail, so they couldn't take a car, so they had to carry me a quarter mile. And I was just like hugging my knees. It was extremely painful. And then I met Zach at the barn, and then Zach picked me up. And that is the story. So Lucy, let me just say, if you don't like blood, you're gonna want to turn this off. But Lucy, when she hit her face, and her teeth went through her lips, and so they were hanging at this point. And they tried to glue them back, and they came unglued, and they couldn't sew them or anything, so they ended up having to cut them off. So unfortunately, she now has like a constant drool and like can't stop that. And then she also has, so that's permanent, unless they find another way to close that, but her teeth are just visible. And her ankles are sore and her hips are sore, so she's probably not going to be riding for a while. It's already been a week. We're both recovering pretty quickly. I saw a physical therapist yesterday. He's just a friend, of our churches, but he was giving me advice on what to do. So I've been walking a little bit without crutches today, but this last week Zach carried me for like the first day until my mom brought crutches over, and then I've been walking on crutches. But I'm in good spirits. I'm super excited to ride again. I don't have fear of getting back on a horse yet, and so I'm excited for whenever that happens. Hopefully in the next week or two, I'll be able to at least either go to the barn or just ride, even if it's just getting back on. I think it's really important. I know it's what a lot of people say. It's super important to ride, to get back on, even if you can ride after. But that wasn't possible for us, so hopefully I'm looking forward to that soon. But I just thought I would update all of you guys and let you know I'm better, I'm in good spirits, I'm bored, I can't dog walk or do very much, so I've just been reading. And yeah, so I'm good. Thank you guys for checking in. Thanks for all the prayers and for all the love. I super appreciate that, and I feel really loved by all of you guys. And if you could, just keep it up, because I'm not completely healed yet, but I'm having faith that I will be healed very soon and ready to more horse adventures. All right, I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.